Hi again, my friends. Today, we are going to talk about the table of showbread. And this time, the showbread itself. Before we start, let's pray. Father, I invite your Holy Spirit to be in our presence. I pray that you will live by the bread that is you. I pray that every single day, you will depend on it as if it gives us life, which it gives us life. I pray all this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. So let's turn to John chapter 6 verse 35 before, as we start. And Jesus said unto them, I am the bread of life. He that cometh to me shall never hunger, and he that believeth on me shall never thirst. So we are focusing a lot on John chapter 6, and it's a chapter about Jesus as the living bread. You can see the word bread repeated many, many times. And in this chapter, many disciples left him because they realized that he was going to build a spiritual kingdom, not a literal kingdom. In verse 51 of the same chapter, I am the living bread which came down from heaven. If any man eat of this bread, he shall live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh, which I will give for the life of the world. So we can see that it is clearly that he is not setting up an earthly kingdom, clearly a spiritual one. Continuing on in verse 63 of the same chapter, it is the spirit that quickeneth, the flesh profiteth nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. So in this verse, it takes a transition. We can see that Jesus said that he is the bread of life and that the word itself gives life. And Jesus is saying that it is flesh. And this is not talking about cannibalism, certainly not. It is to actually eat the word of God, symbolically to consume, to digest the word of God. So if we want to keep living and not allow sin to kill us, we got to eat this bread that gives life. Like when we breathe, we need oxygen to give us life. Same goes to us. If we want to live, we need the word of God, the bread. And you see, this is a trap that we fall into. Sometimes we miss our devotion, didn't have time, we are rushing. We get to be so careful about it, and no, we need to be very careful about it. And we go throughout the day and we didn't seem to do anything bad. But we seem to get this self-security thinking that we are fine without reading the Bible for the day. But if you don't eat the bread, you will eventually die, my friends, because the bread will give life. So, are you going to die if you don't eat one meal? Answer is of course not, right? But you have less strength and less strength. And, you know, your strength to resist temptation will be much less. And how do you know what level of strength you have? You never know, you cannot gauge it. You just have to keep on eating. So that's why sometimes we miss our devotion and becomes like we are very self-secured. To miss once in a while, it's okay. But let me tell you, it's not okay. It will eventually catch up to us, my friends. It cannot be a habit. It should not be a habit. It must be a daily encounter, like what I said in the last lesson. You got to have direct, clear information from God, not a second-hand information from or through someone else. God wants to speak to us directly today, that is through the Word of God that you're reading. You know, the irony is that we cannot forget to eat our meals, our breakfast, our lunch, our dinner. We rarely forget. But we forget that the one that gives us life is the Word of God, and yet that we discard it away. And in John chapter 6 verse 56, he that eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood dwelleth in me, and I in him. Clearly this Bible verse is saying that if we want God to live in us, if we want God to dwell with us, to guide us, we need to eat the Word of God. We need to consume, we need to have our daily devotion. Like how we eat our meals, it's the same thing, my friends. So, that last verse in Matthew chapter 4 verse 4, but he answered and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. My friends, bread is necessary. But more importantly, we need to live by every word. We need to live by every word. And every word gives us life. So my friends, if you want life today, if you feel that your spiritual life is going down, If you feel that your devotional life, your encounter with God through the Bible is missing, I pray that you will start now. You will start, it's not too late. It will give you life. So, remember, the Word of God is crucial to us, like how we need to eat every single meal. And when we miss it, what happens to us? We become weaker and weaker. And how do we know that we are weak in spiritual life? It's hard to tell. And once it happens, you never know. It's just too late. So while you're listening to this, open the Bible after this. Have your devotion so that the Word of God can give you life. Let's pray. Your Father in Heaven, thank you so much for this time that I can share with everyone about the importance of the table of showbread, about the Word of God. It gives us life. We need to eat it. We need to consume it, O Father. And as we eat our meals, let us not forget to also have the Word of God. I pray that we will not miss our devotions. We will not take it for granted, but we will realize that every single meal is important and we will not skip it. I pray all this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.